Good morning. I'd be giving an update on my inverter this morning. I place an external fan on the inverter. What I notice is the internal fan doesn't come on. I wanted to put it direct, but the fans inside the inverter is 12 volts. So I ordered a 24 volt fan, but meanwhile I put a external fan from a microwave oven on it, run it to 220, because down here our electricity is 220. I was repairing a Shoemaker battery charger, which is 110, and I had the inverter running. All of a sudden, everything shut down. I forgot all about the inverter. Was on and it shut down. When I check my panel, that's the electric panel, I notice there was no current. So I went to the switch I have outside, the transfer switch, and I put the electricity back on, which is the mains. And when I came down here to the basement, I saw the inverter was off, but it was over either 60C or 60-something C. I can't remember exactly now. So, which means it has a thermal cutoff in it, which they stated in the description. It shut it down. The fan didn't come on at that temperature, so I decide to put, for now, an external fan on it just to blow the outside until I get the 24 volts. When I do get the 24 volts, I will be wiring it direct on the 24 volts internally and put one of these things on it. That's a thermostat. It's rated for 45C. So let me show you all what I did meantime, because if the inverter keeps getting hot and shutting down when I run something very high, for instance the transformer, and fixing that battery charger, which goes up to two, I think it's a quick start, goes up to 250 something, I can't remember right now. And that inverter keeps shutting down, which it runs the house with no problem. But if I put external load on it and it keeps shutting down, I'm afraid that the components in it will get weak. So I decide to put the external fan. This is what I did. This is the fan here. I run the wires. I put the thermostat right here on this thing on the body, and I connected it here, which is the output from the inverter. This also has a thermostat, a temperature sensor, I put it on this. So I'll be monitoring the temperature of the inverter on here. What I realized, this has two sensors, one on this side, one on the other side. The fans are separate, they are not together, but they are separate. So I don't know if the internal fans, and it has a speed sensor which would rev up the speed. But when I do wire it, the thermostat would put it on. It goes up to 45C. At 45C, it would put on the fan, and it would be blowing. I won't have it constantly. But when I do get the other fan and put the internal fans in it, I'll still have this one. For if in case something go wrong with the internal fan, I have a backup. This would just cool the outside of the case, but it would also blow air inside through the internal fans and come out on this side. I hope everything works out well. Apart from that, I don't have a problem with the inverter. I will be putting my MPP charge controller up today. I would leave this one as a backup because the MPPT gives problem. I think I have one of the fakes or clones, however they call it. So this is it for this video. This is an update on the inverter installed, and when I'm putting up the MPPT, the EP ever, I would show. I have the MPT50. I replace it. I'll be using it for the other one. The other one is a 4210, which is higher than the one I had. The one I had was a 3210, which is a 30 volt. It worked for 3 days and it conked out. I will go more in detail about it and it conking out, what I think happened. But I think these clones have a problem. This is it for this video. If you find it was informative, please like, comment, subscribe, click on the bell icon so you'd be notified of further videos. Until the next one, goodbye and thank you.